When I was younger, I used to prank my family all the time. I used to prank my friends. And then it gets to a point where you realize that you can actually do it for a living. It's my life. I do lots of other stuff. My Facebook is mainly comedy sketches and pranks. My YouTube, I try and do everything that's like vlogs, travel vlogs, interviews, social experiments, pranks, challenges. Might do a bit of makeup every now and then.
And is there anything that you don't do? Ooh, makeup fans?
Can't dance like these two on the front row. That's something I need to do.
Okay.
It's good that you don't, but oh my God, I get so nervous all the time. I'm like, is someone going to hit me? Like,
when you're stealing people's food?
Yeah, I mean, people don't like having their food stolen, you know? Who would have thought? But it's terrifying.
Yeah? And has anything gone tragically wrong with food stealing, earphone cutting?
I just had one video where this guy, like, grabbed my arm really, really, really hard, and I was, like, kind of joking, but actually really hurt.
Yeah, well, you tried to steal my nuggets, so, you know, yeah, don't do that again.
But I did this one, it was quite a while ago, and it was, like, my first quite big public prank where I realized it could go really wrong, and it was like the stealing dog prank. So it sounds really bad, it's not. Basically, I had a dog and I had my friend who was acting to pretend to come along and take it away from someone that I'd asked to babysit the dog.
So you asked someone to, can you look after my dog, you go away?
Yeah, so I sat down with the dog, my phone rang, and I was like, oh, I'm really sorry, could you look after my dog for a minute? Obviously they say yes because it's a cute dog. Then like 5 minutes later, my friend comes along and he's like, huh, this dog looks expensive, can I pet it? They're like, yeah. He's like, can I hold it? They're like, ooh, okay. So he picks it up and like runs away. And people really freaked out. Like this one woman was basically reduced to tears. Like the beginning of the video is like the best thing that's ever happened in a prank. There were like 20 to 30 people in Primrose Hill chasing after my friend. And like, I didn't know what to do. I was like, should I tell them it was fake? So I decided to just join in. It was quite fun.
Amber? Is anyone's dogs okay? Yeah.
You get so many different reactions. The amount of times I've done something and I'm like, oh, it's just a prank. And they're like, you're not using this footage. And I'm like, well, you just ruined my whole video. Thanks for that. But you kind of have to go along with it. Like, you can blur people's faces, but people have to know you can't upload without their permission. So I always make sure I tell them. You get different reactions. Some people are like, oh, it's fine. Some people are like, I will chase you home and stab you, but it's fine. You get used to it.
What would be your ultimate dream prank?
Generally, just pranking Donald Trump in any way possible.
Donald Trump prank. Any ideas? What, you steal his dog as well?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Obviously, everyone wants to kind of be on TV, like the whole punk show, doing something similar to that would be amazing. But the way Facebook's going at the moment with like the video tab, kind of making series, just doing a regular series on Facebook, maybe every week where you do something similar, getting all the public involved, maybe bringing in different creators, getting them to prank their friends, like that'd be really cool. I don't really think that brands like pranks at all. Like,
yeah.
Like, no. Like, I've had loads of brand deals with comedy sketches and everything, but never really with a prank, which is silly because there's so many, like, product placement opportunities. Like, I could do stealing people's Fanta. There's a great brand deal.
It's quite a big one.
Yeah. I mean, I only started 9 months ago, but obviously I post my content on YouTube and Facebook. And when I used to watch YouTube, I used to see so many pranks on YouTube and not on Facebook, and now it's completely changed. Like, people don't want to watch one... Obviously, it's different for, like, a couple of pranks, but generally just one person doing a prank. They don't want to watch 5 minutes of one thing. So Facebook, like, if it's one idea or, like, a compilation of different pranks in one video, that's what people love, which I'm seeing more and more happening recently that I didn't actually see a couple of years ago.
Okay, have you noticed a change in your own content? Do you think you've adapted it to different things, or have you always kind of done the similar path?
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty much the same, just because I know what works for me. But certainly I do see what is out there, and then I think, oh, maybe sometimes, like, I've been making my videos shorter, definitely, just because as a prankster, when I watch other pranks, if it gets to the point where I'm like, oh, is this video over yet, that's when you know you need to cut it down a bit.
Okay.
Success of a prank really does depend on, like, the weather and the time of the year and the location. The amount of times that I like to try and get my prank videos filmed in 2 hours, it's just, like, something that I have in my head that I'm like, oh, I'm just going to go out, get it done in 2 hours. But sometimes you can't, like, if it's raining, people really don't react well and you just don't get the reactions. Or maybe you go somewhere and it's not the best location. And there's been times, like, I work a lot with Jason, who's over there, and he was telling me recently that he did this video and it took him, like, 3 weeks to film because you can stay out for a whole day and if you don't get the reactions, there's nothing you can do. So you've just got to go out another day and another day and another day to get the great reactions, but it's what you have to do.
What's been, like, your longest build-up to a video to film?
The thing is, like, there's lots of planning that you have to do in your head. Like, you have to prepare for the worst. You have to think, oh, okay, say I want these 8 reactions. Maybe I'm going to have to film 20 different people because what's the likelihood of people actually giving you the exact reactions that you want? So maybe like a week or something.
Yeah.
We brainstorm ideas. So I try and figure out what I'm doing. Like, I've got some that I filmed and edited, but I just haven't had a chance to release.
Okay.
So I did one recently with, I realized I said I hadn't done any branded work with pranks, but I actually have, I forgot my bad. So if you guys know Top Gear, Clarkson, Hammond, and May moved on, created their own company called Drive Tribe. So they recently were like, let's do some pranks together. I love Top Gear. So I was like, yay. So we did a reverse gold digger prank with a Lamborghini Huracan, which was sick, and I cannot wait to release the video. It's going to be so funny.
And how did you... Okay, so how did you... Can you tell us about the prank itself and how you did it?
I don't want to tell you too much. But yeah, so the guy that I did the stealing dogs video with, he was involved. So we did it again from like a guy-girl perspective. I don't want to give away the whole video,
because I want you guys
to watch it. Basically, just trying to chat people up. Obviously, if you chat up a random in the street, they're going to say no. And then it kind of got to the point where we'd get the car involved and kind of not say this is our car, but then they realize we have this amazing car. And it's actually shocking the amount of people that changed their answers. Like, I wasn't really expecting that many good reactions, but some people literally went from hell no to oh my God, yes, can we go for dinner now? And I'm like...
Just because of a nice car?
Yeah, I was so surprised. Like, what?
That is mad.
I think people are becoming more understanding. But like when I started, I think it was kind of the opinion of it's like a quick and easy way to get views because pranks do get so many more views than comedy sketches. Like I know I do both. I think now it's okay, but back in the day, I don't really think people looked at pranksters as real creators. They'd just be like, oh, you just go out and you just kind of take people's stuff or trip people up for a video. It's not really creating content, but it still is, and you're still creating content that's entertaining and making people laugh. It's the exact same as making like a comedy sketch or doing an interview. My mum's a magistrate, so whenever I do a prank, I go to her and I'm like, mum, is this legal?
Your mum's a magistrate?
She's a magistrate, so I ask her for like the legal side.
Okay.
She's like, no, this isn't legal. I'm like, cool, I'm going to do it anyway. But it's always good to know, like, I'd say don't do anything that's illegal. I know that sounds stupid, seeing as how what I do, but don't do it because you can get a lot of backlash. Like, I'm kind of prepared to fight people if I have to, but just if you're younger, don't do illegal stuff.